Hello my loves and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm coming to you guys with a pretty decent haul video. I always say that, don't I? So I went shopping at Sigma and Sephora and I will be showing you guys what I picked up, and I got myself into some deep crap. As always, per usual. Okay. So I finally hit VIB status at Sephora. I think you gotta spend, oh wait, it's upside down. I think you have to spend, I don't know. I really don't know how much you have to spend. I'm assuming it's at least $350 or $400. I don't know. I don't know the rules. I barely shop at Sephora, but I have been shopping periodically when I get a coupon or when there's a particular item I like it. So the first item I picked up was an item that I've been eyeballing for a little bit, and I wanted it, but I just didn't know if it would be great. But because it's winter and my lips are dry, my skin is dry, everything's dry, I went ahead and picked up the Bite Beauty Agave Lip Mask, and this is in the color Champagne, which is the new color that came out, and it is this pretty little tube here. Now it is a pain in the butt to get out of this tube, and because my office is freezing, I have to bring it into my bedroom because it's nice and warm. But I usually wear this at night, and I've used it the last four nights, and my lips feel softer. I had really, really dry skin, and by that first night, my lips were nice and conditioned, and I was able to wear lipsticks that day without them hurting too much. And then I used it a couple times throughout the day and at night the next day, and my lips were back to normal. So that's always nice. It is a little bit pricey, but it is so worth it to me so far. Especially for this time of year. And of course I like the color Champagne. It just leaves a nice little shimmer on the lips. It's nothing too overpowering. I think they just did that to change it up a little bit so it doesn't look like Vaseline. Next thing I picked up was something that I wanted a long time ago, but they didn't have the color that I was color matched with, and it was the Becca Ultimate Coverage Complexion Cream Foundation, and this is in the color Nude. Now I was color matched in the color Noisette, which is a darker shade from this, and I went to the store the other night and I took Noisette and I took Nude because I know I'm high yellow, but I needed something that wasn't so pale and matched my skin. I went ahead and put Noisette right there, and then I put Nude, and the Noisette was like a lot darker. Like I would have looked like an Oompa Loompa for me. So I went ahead and got the Nude, and I was like, I hope that the lighting here is giving me the true color. I don't want to have to go back to the store and return. It's just a pain in the ass to do. But I put it on today for the first time. One, I really think this foundation is full coverage. I only used one pump, and I applied it with a kabuki brush, and it applied very well. It applied evenly. There is no streaking with this foundation, and I'm so happy that I color matched myself and that I got the right shade, because I think Nude is a perfect shade for me. Like, I don't know if it's gonna translate on the camera, but I don't care. It goes. The last thing I picked up at Sephora was my first ever Hourglass ambient lighting blush. And I got Dim Infusion, and oh my god, I was gonna get the palette, but it did not have this shade. When I saw this shade, I just knew that it was for me. I didn't wear it today, kind of sad, but it's beautiful. It is a peachy golden highlight, so it has like a golden highlight to it, and it has the peachy side. And when I put them together on my hand, they just look so soft and glowy and oh my god. I cannot wait to try this. Of course, I wanted their palettes, but I kind of decided to just start off with one blush. Even though I want both of the palettes and I will be getting them eventually, one day, maybe, I definitely am so happy that I picked this up because this is a blush that I kind of gravitate towards. So I went ahead and went to Target, and I was picking up some last minute gifts, just some little extras here and there, and I ended up picking up, this isn't makeup related, but I ended up picking up the Impressions Isotoner gloves, and these are the smart touch technology. Not that I think it matters, but I guess you'll be able to, you know, touch your touch screen with it. Which is, I guess, nice if you have to make an emergency call if you're stranded on the road and your hands are cold. So, I don't know, I picked these up. These were buy one, get one half off at Target, and I was super, super excited to pick up a pair. So I did. Next thing I picked up at Target was the Sonia Kashuk Radiant Boost Restorative Facial Oil. I have used this a couple times. I just put it back in the package because, I don't know, I feel like if I tip it over, it might get oily. I don't know. But this is pretty good stuff. There's a whole bunch of oils in here. I'll read it to you. They got sweet almond oil, bergamot essential oil, jasmine essential oil, sesame seed oil, evening primrose oil, black currant seed oil, bariti oil, sea buckthorn berry oil, and last but not least, gold of pleasure oil. I have no idea what kind of oil that is, but this is pretty amazing. I've used it a couple times because my skin is so dry, and I don't know, you just need a couple drops. I put it on my dry areas, my nose and all that stuff, and when you twist it, the top, I don't know if you can see there, the top pops open, so that kind of removes the stopper, and then you twist it and it comes with a dropper. So I went to Walmart and picked up a couple things for the home and stuff, and then I came across these lashes. These are the Salon Perfect Demi Wispies, and it says customer favorites, and I just picked these up. I was gonna pick up a 4-pack to put in my kit just to kind of have, even though I have a whole bunch of lashes in there. I don't own any wispy like lashes. I own very like dark straightforward lashes. I am wearing lashes today, but these are my red cherry lashes that kind of broke on me, so I just cut them and put them on my second half of the end of my eye. But these are really, really pretty, and they're like $2.99. The last stop I made was at sigma.com, and I ended up picking up a whole crap load of brushes. Now, I got these for Cyber Monday because they had their 20% off coupon, which is the same as their pro discount, so it's not much different. But I just wanted to splurge, and I picked up some brushes. So the first brush I will be doing my first impressions on, it's what I applied my makeup with today, is the Sigma 3D HD Kabuki brush. And yes, I thought this was very gimmicky, I'm not even gonna lie. I was like, whatever, they're just trying to come up with a new brush. And I must say, I really like this. You will see my kind of more in-depth first review on it. First impressions review, makes no sense. So I picked it up in white. I kind of wish I would have picked it up in the black, but I don't know, I guess I wanted to be able to tell the brushes apart. I don't know where my logic was, but either way, it's not neither here nor there. I ended up getting a free lip gloss, and this one is in Sheila. I'm not gonna open it because I can send this to a friend of mine, and it's very glittery, but I have a feeling that it's gonna be a sheer pink, which is really pretty. But I don't use glosses like that, and I have a buttload of glosses that I've swatched and that I will just be giving away to my friend anyway. So I'm just gonna give this away, but it was a nice gift. So I pretty much wanted to add some copper brushes to my collection. It looks very similar to rose gold, so I went ahead and picked up a few brushes, a few, like a lot to some. So I ended up getting the Large Angled Contour F40 brush. This is going to be maybe for the cheeks, so I don't know, but this will be nice for contouring and also applying some highlight. So we'll see what this brush ends up being used at, but I'm not in a rush to use it. I just wanted to add it to my collection. Next brush I picked up, it's gonna probably be one of my favorite brushes for highlighting, and it is the Tapered Highlighter F35 brush. I have its big brother, which is the F25, and if you guys are wondering what the difference in brushes are, pretty massive. Of course, I use this for right under the eyes and just to kind of blend out on the rest of the face. So I definitely highlight like my setting highlight powders under the eye, and then I just pretty much set the rest of my face after I'm done using it. I pretty much swirl it out and clean it out for next use. But this one, I think it'll be perfect for highlighting. I picked up two eye brushes that you guys have seen me use, and I picked up the F35 brush, which is the blending brush. I also picked up an F25 brush, which I use for the crease. It's very similar to the 217 brush from MAC, so it is great for a nice wash of color all over the lid, and definitely great for blending that outer V and all over. If you're looking for just one Sigma eye brush, this would be probably the one I recommend, the E25. So of course I had to give in and get these two brushes because I've seen them a lot in videos and I'm like, oh, I gotta get my hands on it. So the first one is the Blending E36, which looks very, 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 very small. It looks like an E35 brush, just literally cut in like a third or half. So I would definitely want to use this to do more cut creases. And I also gave in and got the Tapered Blending Brush, and this is the E40. And this looks very, very similar to a brush that I obsess with, and it is my Sonia Kashuk 109 brush. The only difference is that this is a tapered point and this is just rounded, but I'm thinking the brush is pretty much gonna be the same. No complaints. And that's pretty much it for my overall haul. So I hope you guys like this video. Please thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Love you guys. Bye.